गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी। इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस हाउ टू क्रिएट अ टेबल इन MySQL। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल जस्ट डिस्कस हाउ टू इंसर्ट अ रिकॉर्ड, हाउ टू इंसर्ट अ सिंगल रो इन अ टेबल। ओके, सो बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग विथ एक्चुअल प्रोग्राम, लेट मी शो यू द टेबल दैट वी हैव क्रिएटेड इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो। ओके, सो इफ वी वॉन्ट टू चेक वेदर the respective table is actually created in the MySQL or not, then for that, first of all, we have to start both services through XAMPP, service of Apache as well as service of MySQL. Okay, so from C drive, open your XAMPP folder, open XAMPP control panel, then start Apache as well as MySQL service. So both services are successfully started here. Then open your browser. In browser type localhost, press enter. Then you will get this page. On this page here you have to click on PHP MyAdmin. So here this is a UI of PHP MyAdmin. On left side here this is our database which we have already created in our last video. Again in this database we insert one table, that is student info table. You can click on this table. We create this table with four columns. So first column is S role, student role, then student name, student department and student marks. Where S role column we make it as auto increment and primary key. So for S role will not provide value, the value of S role will be automatically incremented by MySQL. So while inserting record in this table, we'll provide only value for student name, student department and student marks. Okay, so let us proceed with program. Open notepad. So as I said earlier, no change in first three statement. We have to import MySQL package, then we have to call connect method. For connect method here, for database we have to pass value as student. Okay, and in this student database we create student info table. So in that table now we'll try to add a record, add one row, rather insert one row. Okay, so how to insert? For that, see here you have to create one variable. You can give any name for this variable. So I'm going to give name for this variable as SQL. Okay, and now in this variable we will store a query to insert a record in a table. Okay, so how to write query? See here syntax of query. You have to write into, then we have to write table name. See here table name, our table name is student info. Okay, so we have to mention table name student info, then in bracket you have to write the column in which you want to insert data. So let us verify column. As I said earlier, in S role will not going to insert data because S role is auto increment. So we'll provide data for S name, S department and S mark. So these column names you have to mention. Okay, so S name, S department and S mark. So here write S name, then S department and S marks. Okay, then rounded bracket complete. You have to complete this rounded bracket here. Then you have to write keyword value. In bracket you have to mention format specifier for this. See S name, when we create table at that time, for S name we assign data type as varchar, S department varchar and S mark is integer. Okay, so even though here first two are varchar and S mark column is of type integer, here we have to mention format specifier. Okay, so how to mention format specifier? Percent S. Okay, then once again you have to write percent S and one more time percent S. See here, this percentage is for S name, this percentage for S department and last percentage for S marks. even though smarks is of type integer, here format specifier you have to mention it as percent s only. Okay, then double inverted complete. So this is how we can write query to insert record into a table. Okay, then press enter. Now here we have to create one more variable. Okay, so I am going to create variable value. Okay, see here, if you carefully observe our previous query for s name, s department, s marks, we have not provided actual values. Here we just provide what, a format specifier. Now through second variable we have to provide actual value for s name, s department and s mark. Okay, how to provide actual value? For that, this value variable you have to make it as tuple. Okay, so I hope that you are already familiar with the concept of tuple in Python. Okay, so if you want to define a tuple, then we have to use this rounded bracket. Now see, for this first percentage we have to provide actual value, and as I said earlier, first percentage will represent s name. Okay, so here let us provide the value for the name of a student. So I'm going to provide value as, let us say, Amit. Okay, then second percentage, now we have to provide a value. So second percentage is for department, so I'm going to provide value for department as computer. Okay, and last percentage is for marks, and marks is of type integer. Okay, so s name and s department are of type varchar, that's why their actual values we provide through double inverted quote. Okay, but s marks is of type integer, that's why here no need to provide that value in value through double inverted quote. Okay, so here you have to make change. Okay, don't make any change in the format specifier. Okay, now this is how we can define value variable. Okay, now next step is using this my cursor, just like our regular process, using this m cursor we have to now call method execute. Okay, now for execute we have to pass two parameter, where first parameter will be variable in which you store query, and second parameter will be variable in which you store a value. Okay, so this is how you have to call execute method if you want to insert a row into a table. Okay, after execution of this line, what will happen? This SQL query will be executed with this value in MySQL. Okay, now means these values, Amit computer 90, will be stored as a first row in student info table. Okay, so here we are trying to make changes in the content of the table. So after calling this execute method, we have to call to store recent changes. We have to call one more function here. That function is commit function. Okay, and commit function always you have to call by using connection object. So here connection object is MDB. Using MDB you have to call commit. Okay, so for what purpose we have to call commit? Commit we have to call to store recent changes in table. Okay, if you forgot to call commit, then these changes will not get reflected in the table. So it is compulsion on programmer that he has to call commit if he is trying to change the content of the table. Okay, and then later on here you can use one print. Okay, here actually see, at the same time we are trying to insert only one row. Okay, so on command prompt, if you want to display message like how many rows are inserted in table, means one row inserted in table, that type of message if you want to display on command prompt, then for that, using this m cursor here, using this m cursor, you can call row count. Okay, see how to write this row count, and here just mention row inserted. Okay, so what will happen, see, this particular part will fetch actually how many rows will get inserted in the student info table. Okay, so as far as this program is concerning, only one row we are trying to insert, so value of this part for this program will be one. So one row inserted. This type of message will get displayed. Okay, on command prompt. Okay, so let us save this program by giving some name. So save. I'm going to give name for this program as insert row dot py. Save this program in Python tutorial folder. Okay, now let us execute this program. Insert row dot py. Okay, so what output we are expecting here after execution of this program? It will just establish connection. Then after recalling this function, this query will be executed and one row will be inserted. So those changes will get saved using commit, and finally we must get this message: one row inserted. Okay, so let us execute this program. See here, I am getting message as one row inserted. Okay, now through UI method, actually which row is inserted? This Amit computer and 90, and its roll number will be by default, it will be 1, because this is the first record that we are trying to insert in our table. Okay, now actually if you want to check whether this row is actually inserted in the student info table or not, then how to verify that? Using UI method you can verify. See, earlier we check whether this student info table is created or not. So once again click on student info. Okay, and then you have to click on browse, and see here you can check. See, recently added row we are getting here, that is 1. So by default this is auto increment, so by default MySQL is assigning roll number for this row as 1, and this is the value that we pass through program. Okay, so if you execute this program once again, so let us change the values. Okay, so I'm going to change value here. Let us make it as Amol. So I'm going to change the department. Okay, so suppose IT and marks 70. Okay, so I'm going to save this program once again. Save, and once again execute this program. So insert row dot py. See, one more row is inserted. Now this time this row will get inserted, and by default its roll number will be 2. Okay, so once again you can verify this. Okay, once again click on browse. See here, second row is inserted, roll number 2, Amol, IT and 70. Okay, so this is how we can insert a single record in a table. So I hope you are getting this point. So that's all for this video. Stay tuned for further updates. Thank you.